call the Board of Education meeting to order. We'll stand and be led in the pledge by Ms. Prokash.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Can I call the call, please? Mr. Lawson? Mr. Levinson?
Here.
Mr. Lewis? Mrs. McAfee?
Here.
Ms. Prokash?
Here.
Ms. Branch?
Here.
Mr. Bensley?
Present.
Mr. Woodhull?
Yes.
Ms. Bishop? Here. I'm going to ask for a motion to change the order of the agenda and move the board president's items to the next item on the agenda. Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Ms. Branch?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mr. Woodhull?
Yes.
Yes. My first item on the agenda this evening is a resolution to approve the adoption of new and revised policies on two readings. Policy numbers 3100, 4100, and 5100, non-discrimination. These are revised policies. Policy number 5765, student harassment and bullying prevention and intervention, a new policy. Policy number 8202, internet safety. This is also a new policy. And I have a motion.
So moved.
Second. Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Ms. Branch?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mr. Woodhull?
Yes.
Yes. My next item is a resolution to reinstate the boys and girls varsity crew teams for the 2012-2013 school year, contingent upon funding through earmarked grants from foundations and contributors to be paid to the district to meet the necessary budgetary appropriation of funding said program. Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second. Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Ms. Branch?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mr. Woodhull?
Yes.
Ms. Bishop?
Yes. At this time, I'd like to ask for a motion to add a resolution to the agenda regarding an agreement with the Newburgh Rowing Club and a lease for the boathouse. Can I have a motion to add this item to the agenda?
So moved.
Second.
Roll call.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Ms. Branch?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Ms. Bishop?
Yes. I have a motion. Be it resolved that the board president is authorized to execute a lease agreement with Newburgh Rowing Club, Inc. for rental of the boathouse during the 2012-2013 school year at a cost of $1. Can I have a motion?
So moved. Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Ms. Branch?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Ms. Bishop?
Yes. That concludes my items. Our next item on the agenda is a report from the superintendent.
Thank you, Madam President. This evening, we are delighted to recognize and congratulate three groups of student athletes who performed with distinction throughout the year. We have prepared certificates of achievement that will be sent to the athletes, and we'll also be presenting several trophies. Congratulations are in order to the students who did such a wonderful job, and thanks to our coaches and all the staff who provided the support they needed. I would like to invite our athletic director, Mr. Jack Major, to join us at the podium to help with the recognitions. Jack. Thank you, Mr. Pizzo.
Good evening, Madam President, Board of Education members, senior cabinet members, parents, athletes, stakeholders in the Newburgh and Wire City School District. There's been a slight change of the order due to one of our student athletes not being able to be here right at the beginning of this meeting, so I am changing my script a little, excuse me. There were 17 teams this year out of the 29 that we sponsored that were recognized by New York State Public High School Athletic Association for achieving Scholar Athlete Team Awards. On these various teams, there are anywhere between 7 and 12 members of the team that are required to maintain over a 90% grade point average. And I'm proud to say, as I just indicated, that we did have 17 of our 29 teams, which involved 172 of our student athletes, maintaining above a 90% grade point average. What I would like to do at this time is we are going to be presenting certificates of achievement to the 172 athletes. However, we're not going to have all 172 receive their certificate this evening. I can appreciate that. But what we are going to do is have representative coaches here representing the fall, winter, and spring teams to accept those certificates on behalf of the other coaching staff, and then they will be distributing the certificates to our student athletes. So at this time, can our coaches please come up? Representing our fall coaches is football coach Bill Bianco. This fall, the girls' tennis team had 9 people, and their average grade point average was 94.741. The girls' volleyball team with 8 members averaged 94.382. Boys' cross country, 7 members, averaged 92.989. Boys' football with 12 members averaged 92.359. Girls swimming and diving with 11 members averaged 92.271, and girls soccer with 12 members averaged 92.014. Again, Coach Bianco will be accepting the certificates that we have for the fall sports. Representing our winter sports, boys track coach Malcolm Burks. Our winter indoor girls team with 12 members averaged 93.752. The boys skiing team with 7 members, 93.006. Boys indoor track and field with 12 members averaged 92.284. And our girls skiing team with 7 members, 90.836. And our spring coaches, represented by Dennis Marr, our girls golf team with 7 members averaged 96.148, girls lacrosse 11 members 94.900, girls track and field 12 members 94.294, boys lacrosse 11 members 92.785, boys tennis 9 members 92.564, boys track and field 91.174, and boys baseball with 11 members, 90.941. Thank you, coaches. We will be distributing these. Oh, we're going to take a picture. Very good. As they're preparing to do that, I know some of you are wondering, these teams do have more members on them than this. This is the requirement by New York State. We take the top students based on the number that I provided for you. There were, in many cases, a number of students who achieved over 90% average, but they needed to be in the top number that was presented to you this evening. As would be expected, Newburgh Free Academy won that first game against old academies by the score of 9-8, and has won many games since that time. This year's team, however, achieved something that no other Newburgh Free Academy team had done in the sport's 123-year history. Besides ending Monroe-Woodbury's 63-game Section 9 winning streak, this group of fine young men, led by Coach Bill Bianco, made it to the New York State Public High School Athletic Association Class AA Championship game. Despite a heartbreaking 21-13 loss to Orchard Park, the team showed tremendous character and was a great representative of our community and represented our school in a very, very positive manner. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time I would like to again recognize Coach Bill Bianco and his coaching staff. Coach, please. Coach Bianco will be presenting all of the team members from this year's team with a certificate of achievement at a later point in time. Now, ladies and gentlemen, one last thing that I have to present, as I've been giving you a little bit of a history lesson this evening. In 1927, 1 year prior to the opening of Newburgh Free Academy on its current Fullerton Avenue location, Athletic Director C. Everett Stevens presided over the first Block N Senior Athletic Awards ceremony. The tradition of recognizing our senior athletes for years of service to Newburgh Free Academy is an honorable gesture. One of the long-standing practices of the Block N tradition involves only recognizing athletes that have continued to compete for Newburgh Free Academy in their senior year. Tradition and history are an important part of athletics, but since our first Block N in 1927, even baseball has adopted the designated hitter in interleague play, football, the forward pass, and helmets with face masks, and basketball initiated a shot clock and a three-point shot. The superintendent and I have decided to make a revision to the long-standing practice involving the Block N Senior Athletic Awards. We both feel that the situation as it currently exists is not acceptable and would like to start recognizing all of our senior athletes. The student athletes that do not compete as seniors will be recognized from this point forward if they have earned two or more varsity letters. And ladies and gentlemen, that's why I stand here before you this evening. We feel that it's important that the names of the 19 student athletes that were excluded from this year's Block N Awards ceremony be read and added to the list of student athletes that have been recognized over the past 86 years for their achievements in Newburgh Free Academy history. So ladies and gentlemen, at this time I'd like to read the names of the 19 student athletes, and if they are present, we'd like to have you come forward to receive your Block N Award. Will Williams, 2 varsity letters, one as a sophomore in basketball and one as a junior in basketball. Fred Whitted, 2 varsity letters, 1 in indoor track, 1 in basketball. Stephanie Rojotis, cheerleading in basketball and cheerleading in football. Jaylene Robinson, indoor track and outdoor track, 2 letters. Shannon Lopez, 2 varsity letters in swimming. Aisha Bryan, a letter in basketball and a letter in outdoor track. Sam Afron, 2 letters in tennis. Gianna Papa, 3 letters in Peru. Angel Lau, 2 letters in indoor track and 1 letter in outdoor track. Sean Dunderdale, 3 total letters, 1 in swimming, 1 in wrestling, and 1 in lacrosse. David Diaz, 3 varsity letters in lacrosse. Kira Dayton, 3 varsity letters in swimming. Yolanda Burks, 3 varsity letters, 2 of them in indoor track and 1 in outdoor track. Kadesha Brown, 3 varsity letters in basketball. Ashanti Atkins, 3 varsity letters in outdoor track. Alexandra Morrill, 5 varsity letters, 3 in crew and 2 in swimming. Mac Jones, 6 varsity letters, 3 in outdoor track, 2 in indoor track, and 1 in football. Christian Chaleski, 6 varsity letters, 2 in outdoor track, 2 in indoor track, and 2 in cross country. And this last gentleman, I hope, is here. Yes, I actually see him there now. And I'm proud to say that I coached him for all of these letters prior to becoming the director of athletics. And although he's an outstanding student, Galen and I found 13 varsity letters and not 12. So he would have been the top recipient of all student athletes that were recognized at Block N. But Galen McCartan, 13 varsity letters. Galen is challenging my math skills, 5 in outdoor track, 5 in indoor track, and 3 in cross country. So once again, Galen would have been the top recipient this year at the Block N Award. Ladies and gentlemen, not forgotten, our Block N Award winner.
Next on our agenda tonight, Madam President, going to recognize board member Nathan F. Vesley as he prepares to conclude his board term. As we know, Mr. Vesley provided outstanding board service during his 3-year term on the board, and we want to celebrate that service and wish Mr. Vesley the best. We have a little token of appreciation for Mr. Vesley, and we ask him to join us at the dais. Association's leadership development training activities, such as Board Officers Academy, legal conferences, regional workshops, and other district-level custom improvement programs. I am delighted to invite our honorees to come to the front of the dais to receive their awards, have pictures taken, and remain at the dais for a group picture. This year, we're awarding the awards of excellence to Dawn Fumcheck, our president, and Pamela Freeman Resch. This concludes my part of the items for this section, Madam President.
Thank you, Mr. Pizzo. Our next item on the agenda is public discussion and comment on agenda items. Anyone wishing to speak on agenda items, please step to the podium and give your name and address. Our next item on the agenda is from the superintendent.
Thank you. We have a number of resolutions tonight. Resolution A is to approve facilities project change orders associated with two projects. South Middle School renovations, Bales Gate Set 1 and 2 renovation projects, and Gardner Town renovation project.
Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mr. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Whitmire?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Bezley?
Yes.
Mr. Pizzo?
Yes.
Resolution B is to award the contract for the district's capital construction project at Newburgh Free Academy North Campus Boys Gym renovations.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll, oh, Ms. Prokash.
I just have one question on the contract one. Will the company that's doing this, I know in the past we constantly had to pay extra for scaffolding. Is scaffolding included in the bid? I mean, it is the roof.
Mr. Dane, you're right. Out of the hallway. Can we get it?
So we'll have to pay extra for that.
Certainly thrilled that you're back. Sorry, Mr. Damon, we'll repeat the question. Go ahead, Ms. Prokash.
Mr. Damon, I just wanted to question on the contract one for the abatement. In that bid, did the company include scaffolding? Because it is the roof, you know, the ceiling. Because we constantly, the last two or three times for extras, we've had to pay for rental of scaffolding.
Yes, this is the interior ceiling of the gymnasium.
I know.
The scaffolding is included. The other projects, we were required to add scaffolding because we discovered asbestos-containing materials on the outside of the building, and they originally were going to do the removal of the windows with lifts. And when we found that we had asbestos, so we moved ahead and installed scaffolding so that we could do the abatement. So there was a change condition on those exterior projects, but this is an interior project. The scaffolding is included as a part of the process.
Because I would rather see, because with the, like abatement, you get a, you know, a, they get the contract, and then there's all these extra unforeseen things. I would rather see any of them put in the scaffolding. If they don't use it, take it off.
Just
Any other questions on this item? Roll call.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee? Yes. Yes, Mr. Edwin?
Yes.
Ms. Mitchell?
Yes.
Resolution C is to approve and accept the revised project budget summary for the $50 million capital project dated June 27, 2012.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Eversley?
Yes.
Mrs. McAdoo?
Yes.
Mr. Phelps?
Yes.
Mr. Eversley?
Yes.
Ms. Mitchell?
Yes.
Resolution D is to approve and accept the revised project budget summary for the $76.5 million capital project dated June 27, 2012.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Eversley?
Yes.
Mrs. McAdoo?
Yes.
Mr. Phelps?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Eversley?
Yes.
Ms. Mitchell?
Yes.
Madam President, I would ask the board to add two items. Resolution E is a resolution with the Apple Company. And Resolution F is an agreement with Dell Financial Services.
Can I have a motion to add Resolutions E and F to the agenda?
So moved.
Second.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Eversley?
Yes.
Mrs. McAdoo?
Yes.
Mr. Phelps?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Eversley?
Yes.
Ms. Mitchell?
Yes.
Resolution E. Be it resolved that the Board of Education authorizes the Board President to execute a master lease purchase agreement, including New York addendum and related documents with Apple Inc. for the lease of computer hardware, accessories, and service as set forth on the attached equipment schedules upon approval of the same by the school attorney. A copy of such agreement shall be incorporated by reference within the minutes of this meeting. 97.12.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawrence? Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAdoo?
Yes.
Mr. Phelps?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Eversley?
Yes.
Yes.
Resolution F. Be it resolved that the Board of Education authorizes the Board President to execute a customer master services agreement with Dell Financial Services, LP, for the lease of computer hardware and or software, as well as a statement of work with Dell Marketing, LP, for work in connection with the deployment of the computers being leased upon approval of same by the school attorney. Copy of such agreement and statement of work shall be incorporated by reference within the minutes of this meeting.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mr. McAdoo?
Yes.
Mr. Phelps?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Eversley?
Yes.
Yes.
That concludes my items, Madam President.
Thank you, Mr. Pizzo. Our next item on the agenda is from the Assistant Superintendent for Student Intervention and Support Services.
Thank you, Madam President. Item A are the recommendations from the Committee on Special Education.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAdoo?
Yes.
Mr. Phelps?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Eversley?
Yes.
Ms. Mitchell?
Yes.
Item B is a resolution to authorize the Superintendent of Schools to execute an agreement with Zicron Industries to perform Medicaid loss prevention and billing services for 2012-2013.
May I have a motion?
So moved.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAdoo?
Yes.
Mr. Phelps?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Eversley?
Yes.
Yes.
Item C is a resolution to approve facility use requests submitted by Goldbacks Youth Football League, Newburgh America Pumas, and Quick Strike Football Club.
Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Yes. Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mrs. Prokash?
Yes.
Mrs. Ratchen?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you, Madam President. That concludes my items.
Thank you, Dr. Moreno. Our next item on the agenda is from the Assistant Superintendent for Curriculum and Instruction.
Thank you, Madam President. My first item is a resolution to authorize the Superintendent of Schools to execute an agreement with Elant at Fishkill for the affiliation of the education of the nurse aide training program for the 2012-2013 school year.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mrs. Prokash?
Yes.
Mrs. Ratchen?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mr. Peacecheck?
Yes.
My next item is a resolution to authorize the Superintendent of Schools to execute a consultant agreement with Capital Area School Development Association to prepare and facilitate on-site consultation to complete the 2012-2013 Comprehensive Education Plan. Funding source is Title I School Improvement.
Can I have a motion?
So moved. Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mrs. Prokash?
Yes.
Mrs. Ratchen?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mr. Peacecheck?
Yes.
My next item is a resolution to approve three members of the NFA tennis team to attend and compete in the State Tennis Championship in Flushing Meadows, New York from May 30th through June 1st, 2012. Funding source, General Funds Athletic Department.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mrs. Prokash?
Yes.
Mrs. Ratchen?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mr. Peacecheck?
Yes.
My next item is a resolution to approve 20 members of the NFA track team to attend and compete in the State Track and Field Championship in Syracuse, New York from June 7th through the 9th, 2012. Funding source, General Funds Athletic Department.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mrs. Prokash?
Yes.
Mrs. Ratchen?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mr. Peacecheck?
Yes.
My next item is a resolution to approve one member of the NFA golf team to attend and compete in the State Golf Championship at Delhi, New York from June 8th through the 10th, 2012. Funding source, General Funds Athletic Department.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mrs. Prokash?
Yes.
Mrs. Ratchen?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mr. Peacecheck?
Yes.
My next item is a resolution to approve conference requests.
Can I have a motion?
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mrs. Prokash?
Yes.
Mrs. Ratchen?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mr. Peacecheck?
Yes.
Thank you, Madam President. That concludes my items.
Thank you, Mr. Forget. Our next item on the agenda is from the Assistant Superintendent of Finance. Mr. Pisa will be reporting for Mr. Pisella.
Thank you, Madam President. Resolution A is to approve property tax refunds as a result of court orders, aka certiorari.
Can I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mrs. Prokash?
Yes.
Mrs. Ratchen?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mr. Peacecheck?
Yes.
Resolution B is to approve bids, number 112, number 12 through 17 cafeteria paper and plastic, number 2, 12 through 18 student snacks, number 3, 12 through 19 cafeteria grocery, 12 through 20 cafeteria meat and frozen meals, and number 5, 12/21/2012, extended school year and summer special ed transportation.
May I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinsky?
Yes.
Mrs. McAvoy?
Yes.
Mrs. Propack?
Yes.
Mrs. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mrs. Futuro?
Yes.
Resolution C is to declare library books, academic kits, and equipment surplus and obsolete and to authorize deposition of the same.
May I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinsky?
Yes.
Mrs. McAvoy?
Yes.
Mrs. Propack?
Yes.
Mrs. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mrs. Futuro?
Yes.
Resolution D, to accept the donation of an indoor soccer goal.
May I have a motion?
So moved.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinsky?
Yes.
Mrs. McAvoy?
Yes.
Mrs. Propack?
Yes.
Mrs. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mrs. Futuro?
Yes.
Resolution E is to accept bills and reports.
May I have a motion? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinsky?
Yes.
Mrs. McAvoy?
Yes.
Mrs. Propack?
Yes.
Mrs. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mrs. Futuro?
Yes.
That concludes the financial report tonight, Madam President.
Thank you, Mr. Pizzo. Our next item on the agenda is from the Assistant Superintendent for Human Resources.
Thank you, Madam President. On the Human Resources agenda, items A through J. On the professional side, we have change of status, return from leave of absence, retirements, and on the civil service side, we have change of status, return from leave of absence, resignation, retirement, college workers, and current and former employees who passed away.
May I have a motion?
So moved.
Questions or comments? Yes, Ms. Propack.
I was wondering if I could have item A table for discussion in executive session. Just for clarification.
Can I have a motion to table item A on this portion of the agenda?
So moved.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinsky?
Yes.
Mrs. McAvoy?
Yes.
Mrs. Propack?
Yes.
Mrs. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mrs. Futuro?
Yes. Can I have a motion for items B through J on the Human Resources agenda? Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinsky?
Yes.
Mrs. McAvoy?
Yes.
Mrs. Propack?
Yes.
Mrs. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mrs. Futuro?
Yes.
Resolution K is to rescind the board action approved in Resolution 053012P, items 10, 14, 18, and 22, and to approve Resolution 0627112K to abolish certain pedagogical positions effective the close of business on June 30th, 2012.
May I have a motion?
So moved.
Questions or comments? Yes, Mr. Levinstein.
This is that we had additional retirees, so there's better layoffs, correct?
Correct.
Any other questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Mrs. McAvoy?
Yes.
Mrs. Propack?
Yes.
Mrs. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Mrs. Futuro?
Yes.
Resolution L is to rescind the board action approved in Resolution 053012Q, item number 10, and to approve Resolution 062712L to abolish certain non-pedagogical positions effective the close of business on June 30th. This is the same as Resolution K, but these are the non-pedagogical positions after we received further resignations or retirements, this affected the layoffs.
May I
Yes.
Mr. Lovinski?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Carpenter?
Yes.
Ms. Brats?
Yes.
Mr. Beasley?
Yes.
Ms. Butcher?
Yes.
Resolution M is to appoint Julio Vasquez as the Director of Elementary Interdisciplinary Curriculum and Assessment as per the NASA agreement and the Board Resolution 042412S creating the position.
May I have a motion?
So moved.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Lovinski?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Carpenter?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Beasley?
Yes.
Ms. Butcher?
Yes.
Resolution N is to appoint the school district clerk effective July the 30th, 2012.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Lovinski?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Carpenter?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Beasley?
Yes.
Ms. Butcher?
Yes.
The next resolution is to approve appointments for the city professional development, creating and managing literacy centers at GAMS, funding sources Title I, school improvement grant.
May I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Lovinski?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Carpenter?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Beasley?
Yes.
Ms. Butcher?
Yes.
Resolution P is to approve appointments for the development of the comprehensive education plans for GAMS and Horizons, funding sources Title I, Part B for elementary schools.
May I have a motion?
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Lovinski?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Carpenter?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Beasley?
Yes.
Ms. Butcher?
Yes.
Resolution Q is to designate individuals eligible for appointment, depending on student enrollment and attendance, to positions for the 2012 extended school year program. These are the appointments of the subs.
May I have a motion?
So moved.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Lovinski?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Carpenter?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Beasley?
Yes.
Yes.
Resolution R is to designate individuals eligible for appointment, depending on student enrollment and attendance, to positions for the 2012 extended school year program for proctoring and scoring.
May I have a motion?
So moved. Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Lovinski?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Carpenter?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Beasley?
Yes.
Ms. Butcher?
Yes.
Resolution S is to designate individuals eligible for appointment, depending on student enrollment and attendance, to positions for the 2012 extended school year program. These are additional appointments.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second. Questions or comments? These are as a result of the exam scores, correct? Finding out how many more kids you had coming in?
Not yet, that'll be next week. These two are correcting an error that was made and one additional for guidance.
Okay, thank you. Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Lovinski?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Carpenter?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Beasley?
Yes.
Ms. Butcher?
Yes.
Resolution T is to approve appointments of individuals for the kindergarten screening and ancillary assistance.
May I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Lovinski?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Carpenter?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Beasley?
Yes.
Ms. Butcher?
Yes.
Resolution U is to approve appointments of individuals for curriculum mapping and assessment development for Stage 1 SLOs, the student learning objectives, funding sources Title I.
I have a motion.
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Yes, Ms.
Prakash. I just have one comment on number 21, it's just a clerical typing error. Should be corrected.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Propack?
Yes.
Ms. Gresh?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Yes.
Resolution B is to rescind the 3020A charges brought against a district employee.
I have a motion.
Move.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Propack?
Yes.
Ms. Gresh?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Yes.
Resolution W is to authorize the superintendent of schools to execute an agreement between the Civil Service Employees Association and the district dated June the 13th, 2012. This is the agreement that establishes the Wednesday through Sunday schedule.
I have a motion.
So move.
Questions or comments? Yes, Mr. Bensley.
Madam President, I would like that resolution tabled for further discussion in executive session.
Can I have a motion to table Resolution W?
So moved.
Second. Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Propack?
Yes.
Ms. Gresh?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Yes.
Resolution X is to certify individuals pursuant to the requirements of Education Law Section 3012C and Part 32.9 of the Region's Rules as lead evaluators for classroom teachers and for building principals. This is part of the APPR regulations. We received training this year and provided training this year to the building principals to prepare them to become lead evaluators, and this certifies that training and their work. Have received the training and are capable to do that work.
I have a motion.
So moved. Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Propack?
Yes.
Mr. Gresh?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Ms. Propack?
Yes.
Resolution Y is to approve the tenure recommendations for an administrator and teachers.
I have a motion.
So moved. Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Propack?
Yes.
Ms. Gresh?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Ms. Propack?
I will abstain.
Resolution Z is to approve an additional professional retirement.
I have a motion.
So moved.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Propack?
Yes.
Ms. Gresh?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you, Madam President. That concludes my items.
Thank you, Mrs. Limer. Our next item on the agenda is from the Clerk of the Board.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. There are several meeting minutes that the Board is approving tonight. They have the regular meeting on May 30th, the special meeting on May 16th, the panel's vote on May 16th, the regular meeting of April 24th, and the special meeting on April 18th.
I have a motion. Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Propack?
Yes.
Ms. Gresh?
Yes.
Mr. Bensley?
Yes.
Ms. Propack?
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Botsford. Our next item on the agenda is public discussion and comment on non-agenda items. Anyone wishing to speak on non-agenda items, please step to the podium and give your name and address. I have received one request, and we will first hear from Mr. Art Plitza.
Good evening. My name is Art Plitza. I am president-elect of the Newburgh Teachers Association.
As I have been meeting with teachers throughout the district, many of my colleagues feel discounted. We all need to work together to support the education of our students in the district. Teachers have incredible years of experience in the classroom that should be valued and respected. Having initiatives simply coming down from above, either from central office or from individual building administrators, does not have the same chance for success as a collaborative model. And I have several specific points. The teacher center. It should be a valuable resource used by teachers for professional development, research and dissemination of best teaching practices. Unfortunately, it has not functioned effectively over the past couple of years. It needs adequate funding from the district, which it had had in the past, and effective administration, and have teacher involvement in professional development decision making. We need to utilize teacher resources in the district. There are teachers who have had extensive training in New York State and in other parts of the country in various curricular areas, but they were never brought back to have discussions about what they've learned. Guidance counselors who have had that connection between teachers and students can provide insight into procedures and policies, but yet they are not asked about their opinions. I discussed a lengthy discussion with guidance counselors, and they said nobody had discussed anything about the new Regents requirement and how that would affect students. And I think that it would probably have made sense to do so. Language teachers, about specific language programs. I mean, there were problems with scheduling Italian, for instance. But those teachers are a resource that could be consulted. There's also the problem with the administration in individual schools. They should be having discussions with the teachers in those schools regarding scheduling issues and the most efficacious use of resources. There was an MOA dealing with tentative schedules with the deadline going from June 1st to June 8th. The purpose of that notification is so that teachers can prepare for the following year and to be as effective as possible. Yet we had many teachers on the secondary level given schedules simply saying TBA or TBD, and one just simply said math. There is no way you can possibly prepare with that as your schedule. How can that possibly be seen as positive for the education of students in our district? I am a nationally board certified teacher. We have several in this district. It's a fantastic program. But yet we've never been brought into discussions on issues related to teaching, related to evaluations, or anything. And it's actually part of the contract that we could be asked to do that, but no one has ever done so. We have contract language that says the district will support this program, and that has not happened this year. It is a terrible waste of a valuable resource. We are all working for the students in the district. We all need to remember that. I would ask you to consider the following. I believe there needs to be a level of respect among all parties that calls be returned, emails will be answered, and all parties will feel that they are heard. This has been a problem at the Newburgh Teachers Association and will be corrected July 1st when I take office. But I would like a commitment from the Board of Education and Central Administration that the effort will be made to treat all parties with the respect they deserve. Anything else seems like arrogance. We need to remind ourselves that none of us are indispensable. No matter how high the position or how large the ego, and we need to try to put ourselves in the shoes of those who need help, who are more fragile than we, so that we approach everyone with compassion and respect.
and give your name and address.
Grace Bowles, Newburgh, New York. This is your final meeting of the school year. You have honored many students, teachers, administrators, and support staff. But I want to really talk about Mary Lou, because Mary Lou is someone who will be replaced, but really, she can't be replaced.
That's right.
She is, if I had to pick out any one person in this district that has a work ethic and congeniality to go along with it, it would be Mary Lou. There's nothing else to say about her except that she is a great individual.
Yes, she is.
And good luck, Mary Lou. But we had another administrator to retire, and I believe that the board members must have forgotten about the person who represents 41% of the children in this district. Carmen Vascatel has worked tirelessly to see that the Latino children receive a fair and good education. There were many high-powered people at her retirement dinner. Oops. Board members were missing. No board members. This lady has worked in this district to move those children along. Mr. Noriega was there, but he doesn't count. And that's a good way, Mr. Noriega. That's a good stop, okay? I'm not dissing you. I'm just saying that there should have been someone there to say, Ms. Vascatel, job well done. But there wasn't. There were over 100 people there, but not one board member.
Wow.
Maybe you were at some other event, but there are at least 7 of you who know what she has meant to the Latino community. So into the hall of disrespect, I put the Newburgh and Lawrence City School District Board of Education. See you next year.
Is there anyone else that would like to make a comment on non-agenda items?
I'd like to thank you all for your service in this semester. It's a pleasure to all of your deals as a portion of the school district. I definitely also heard that you guys are reinstating the routine with that Leggins have another chance. I want to thank you for that. I think that's definitely is a nice way to go. I like the fact that we are not going to be taking anything away from any other programs, and especially any teachers or aides or anything. That's a good idea. And I think this is a wonderful, you're giving us a great chance, and you're doing a great thing for the school district. I think it's going to be really good. And so I really want to say thank you for giving us this opportunity. You guys are in a good situation for both of us. About a year ago, I received a phone call from a woman who identified herself as the great-great-granddaughter of Ellis Ward. And I knew who the Wards were because that's who the city has named, us named the park after the Wards. And she told me that her great-great-grandfather went to Newburgh Academy. That was great. So, you know, and I knew that they had been professional rowers. And I had never, you know, and I said, well, that, you know, that's good. And they were world champion rowers. That was a good thing. Until 2 days ago, I had never, you know, I'm a history buff. And I'm always looking around about history and researching and finding about this. Two days ago, I researched and I found out in the University of Penn history books where I found out that he actually, when he was in high school, was a junior high school rowing champion. So that meant that he was the first athlete of the Newburgh Academy to compete in the sport, which was rowing. At the time, this was before there were any other sports, before baseball, before football, before track, before any other sports. Rowing was the sport that took place here in Newburgh. That's one of the reasons why I chose to get involved in sports. I am this history buff. When I found this out, reading this stuff from the University of Pennsylvania, I found out that this man also, Ellis Ward, was the greatest college coach, I guess, ever, for from 1880 to 1910. He was throughout America. He was equivalent to what we would think of Newt Rockne, which came later on to football. And this was a man that grew up here in Newburgh. And this woman told me he went to Newburgh Academy. Great thing, and now that we have made the circle, bring the crew back again, it's a great thing. I also found out the man who made these boats really fast and changed the whole design and everything for rowing is the one who built, I think his name still has the contract, oh, there he is, he's outside there, it's Damon, the contractor who built the original Newburgh Free Academy. Was Thomas Shaw's son. Was the original contractor that went all over America building these rowing sheds, because that was the big thing back in the late 1800s. He's on the plaque over at Montgomery Street, the old Montgomery Street School. So, a little bit of history that ties in to the whole crew thing that's going on with us getting a chance to come back again. It is a good thing to keep this thing. Historically, I'd love to invite all you guys to come down there and see what we've done. I know that a few of you have, but I'd love to have all of you come down there and see that this is a worthwhile thing. And see that I'm very glad that you've given us this chance to save this here. And I want to thank you all for doing that. Thanks a lot.
This can be a model for other things in the future, and we can get a lot of other things, other activities done as well.
Absolutely. Thank you. Any other comments on non-agenda items? I'm just going to take a moment to acknowledge Mrs. Boxberg this evening. This is her last official board meeting. Her retirement date is effective June 30th. Mm-hmm. And although our new district clerk won't be starting until July 30th, so she'll be around, this is truly her last official meeting. And I don't think think that we will ever be able to express to her what she has done for each and every one of us. She is literally the board's right-hand person. We couldn't function without her, and she helps us beyond belief, and she will truly be missed more than she will ever know, and I hope that she can feel our love and appreciation for her years of service and what she's given to this district and what she's given to every Board of Education that has come before her. So thank you, Mrs. Botsford.
Am I doing the least one too?
Whichever one you want to do.
Okay.
All right, Joan.
Okay. I'm going to do that last.
Okay.
We would need a resolution, Madam President, to remove from the table human resources, agenda items A and W.
Can I have a motion to remove HR resolutions A and W from the table?
So moved. Second.
Roll call.
Mr. Watson?
Yes.
Mr. Lockstein?
Yes.
Mr. Lockstein?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Fresh?
Yes.
Ms. Wesley?
Yes.
Yes.
Resolution A is a professional change of status.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Fresh?
Yes.
Mr. Bisley?
Yes.
Mr. Kuchek?
Yes.
Resolution W is to authorize the superintendent of schools to execute an agreement between the Civil Service Employees Association and the district dated June 13th, 2012.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Rash?
Yes.
Mr. Bisley?
No.
Ms. Kuchek?
Yes.
Next, we need a resolution to add under the superintendent, or the board president. Where does that lease go, the board or the superintendent?
Authorizes the board president, okay. So I guess under me.
So under the board president to add resolution C to the agenda.
Can I have a motion to add resolution C to the agenda?
So moved.
Second.
It's actually D. Oh, no. Yes, it's D, because Boathouse lease was C.
Okay.
And resolution D to the agenda. Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levinson?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Prokop?
Yes.
Ms. Fresh?
Yes.
Ms. Wesley?
Yes.
Ms. Kuchek?
Yes.
Resolution D, be it resolved that the Board of Education hereby approves a one-year lease agreement with Silverman-Gidney LLC for the lease of office storage space at 337 Fullerton Avenue, Newburgh, New York, effective July 1st, 2012 through June 30th, 2013, at a monthly lease rate of $2,000, and be it further resolved that the Board hereby authorizes the Board President to execute a one-year lease agreement with Silverman-Gidney LLC upon approval of the same by the school attorney. Copy of such lease agreement shall be incorporated by reference within the minutes of this meeting.
Can I have a motion?
So moved. Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call.
Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levitsky?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Concox?
Yes.
Ms. Rich?
Yes.
Mr. Missling?
Yes.
Ms. Sukar?
Yes. We need a resolution to add under Human Resources three resolutions, AA, BB, and CC.
And I have a motion to add resolutions AA, BB, and CC to the agenda.
Yes, yes.
So moved. Second.
Roll call.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levitsky?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Concox?
Yes.
Ms. Rich?
Yes.
Mr. Missling?
Yes.
Yes.
Resolution AA, be it resolved that the board hereby ratifies the provisions of a memorandum of agreement entered into by the negotiating teams for the Newburgh Supervisors and Administrators Association and the district dated June 26, 2012, that sets forth the terms of a one-year successor collectively negotiated agreement, and be it further resolved that the board hereby authorizes the expenditure of those monies necessary to fund the provisions of the 2012-2013 agreement between the district and the NSAA.
May I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levitsky?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Concox?
Yes.
Ms. Rich?
Yes.
Mr. Missling?
Yes.
Ms. Kuchar?
Yes.
Resolution BB. Be it resolved that the Board of Education hereby authorizes the Board President to sign the district certification form for submission of the district's APPR plan document for the 2012-2013 school year and beyond for teachers covered pursuant to Education Law 3012C and Part 30-2.5 to the State Education Department.
Can I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levitsky?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Concox?
Yes.
Ms. Rich?
Yes.
Mr. Missling?
Yes.
Ms. Kuchar?
Yes.
And Resolution CC, be it resolved that the Board of Education hereby approves the terms of and appropriates the funds necessary to implement a supplemental memorandum of agreement dated June 26, 2012 between the district and the Newburgh Teachers Association concerning the annual professional performance review for the 11-12 school year for teachers covered under Education Law Section 3012C and Part 30-2.4 of the Regents Rules, as well as for the 2012-2013 school year and beyond for teachers covered under the Education Law Section 3012C and Part 30.25 of the Regents Rules. A copy of said SMOA, as presented to the board at this meeting, shall be incorporated into the district's APPR plan document for the 11-12 school year and for the 2012-13 school year and beyond, and shall be incorporated by reference within the minutes of this meeting.
May I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Questions or comments? Roll call, please.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes.
Mr. Levitsky?
Yes.
Ms. McAfee?
Yes.
Ms. Concox?
Yes.
Ms. Rich?
Yes.
Mr. Desmond?
Yes.
Ms. Kuchar?
Yes.
That's it. Thank you.
And I have a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Thank you very much, everyone.